We're going to start. Probably one of the most important functions that government can have is to protect taxpayers and restore the public trust. And that's one of the reasons why we're putting forward these proposals that seek to limit the authority of the quasis in our state of Connecticut. Now, on the boards behind us, on this side behind Senator Logan and Senator Martin, are headlines that probably every reporter in this building has written a story regarding the quasis in this state running afoul, whether it's the Port Authority, the Lottery Commission, the Housing Authority, Access Health, the Green Bank, the Connecticut Housing Authority, Capital Regional Development Authority. Every one of these quasis in the last 3 or 4 years have had issues that has caused the public to question what they're doing. We believe that something needs to be done about it. And I will say this, Governor Lamont himself said in June, July, August, September, October, that he was going to do something. He said it is time for leadership to be intrusive. It is time for him to take this issue. In fact, he sent a letter to all the leaders indicating that it was time for us to come together in a bipartisan way and bring about a bill that was going to limit and have oversight over the quasis. To further that end, there even was a meeting with all the leaders in the Capitol where we all talked about the ideas, Republicans, Democrats, House, Senate, and there were other people, I can't remember who else, but there were other people in that room. I think the comptroller was in there as well, or somebody from his office in the treasurer, to talk about limiting the powers of these agencies. We were promised that there would be a bill that would come out that we all can sign on and we present this session. When we saw there wasn't a bill, that in fact in the bonding proposal put forth by the governor is to fund $45 million to a quasi that went into effect vis-a-vis a partisan budget that has no members, no appointees, haven't even met, no rules, just abstract powers, and you're going to give them $45 million in a bonding package, not even knowing who you're trusting. We decided it was time for us to stand up and say, we need to have control over these quasis. And another quasi should not be formed, and no money should be given to the quasis until and unless we have in place those limitations of powers that restrict the use of taxpayers' money. That's what our proposals are about. Now, from a broad concept, we talk about fiscal, we talk about ethics, we talk about the composite of the board, and legal reforms, all of which are very important to make sure all of us know what's happening with the quasis. Every quasi hires their own counsel. So when you're a legislator and you ask for information, they get to hide behind attorney-client. Well, the Attorney General represents the state of Connecticut. And the Attorney General should be used for these things. And we should know when there's an issue. We should not be stonewalled. When a quasi once said to me, a couple years ago, I was asking questions about what they're doing in their quasi, they answered, Senator, you shouldn't care. We give money to the state of Connecticut. That's not the answer. We create you. You are beholden to us as a legislature as we are beholden to the taxpayers that the money is being used. We have a right to know. And what happens is they go off, salaries get inflated, their commissions given in addition to salaries that none of us, I bet you there's very few legislators, if any in this building, know that one of the quasis get a salary plus commissions on the deals that they make. I don't think people know about that in the building. I don't think they really know how much money these folks are really making. And whether it's good or bad, we could decide. But we need to know. It has to be shown to the legislature. So we propose to put forth the bill, and we've asked the committee to raise it at GAE. Rob Sampson was going to be here. He had an event, so he could not be here. But we're going to put forth the GAE, the right to have a public hearing. And we've put these in years and years at a time, and they've all been rejected by the majority. Last year, I think the Senate Democrats put one in, and we were assured that we'd have a bipartisan bill this year. So with that, we are asking this legislature to go forward, hear this, and move this accordingly. We'd like to do it bipartisan. We'd like to sit down with the folks on the other side of the aisle, and I'm sure we will have that opportunity. Are there any questions?